And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat, and everybody on YouTube for some Jayce Senna. This is a deck that a lot of people have kind of been asking about if they think that it would work or not. I did not build a specific list. This was another viewer-submitted donation deck, but the list looks pretty good. The thinking behind the two champions is the Senna can give your damage and kill spells fast speed. So therefore, our Piercing Darkness and our Shock Blast that are normally slow speed, we can make those fast speed. That really helps out against open attacks and everything like that. And being able to cast those during combat is really nice. And so that's like the thinking here, is putting those together. One little thing that I would kind of like some of the two damage spells like Vile Feast, Unspeakable Horror. But you know, we'll just see how it goes. We do have all these Thermogenic Beams that can help out against early stuff. Again, making Thermogenic Beam fast speed could be pretty cool with Senna. And besides that, you know, we have a couple Sentinels to make some darkness, the Solari Sentinel and the Ixtali Sentinel. The Ixtali Sentinel also has that Lifesteal, help us stabilize. A couple of Time Tricks and Glimpse Beyonds for some card draw. And then early units that are just going to be good early blockers that also help refill our spell mana or get super cool expensive thing. Pharaoh's Financier in particular is really good with Shadow Isles, with all these awesome 6+ cost spells in Shadow Isles. Okay, so here we go. Let's go ahead and give this a try. We'll play some Jayce Senna. We'll go play 5 games in ranked. Nerf asks, do you guys think there should be a different category for landmarks that take a long time to count down? Seems kind of unfair when I invest a lot of cards into a Thrall to just get it scorched earthed later. Yeah, that's the give and take. I don't think there needs to be any different category for that, but that's the risk that you take whenever you're only putting one mana investment into a card that'll get you an 8-8 overwhelm. I can still, you know, that can be a thing. All right, so we're playing against what I think is maybe the best deck, Zed Poppy. I think Zed Poppy just is always incredibly scary and attacks for a lot of damage and all that kind of stuff, and it can do some crazy stuff. So we'll see how we do there. We do have a decent amount of removal. Oh man, I like making that trade, but we kind of need to save this for their champions, I guess, because we don't have other removal spells. And I kind of want to take that assembly line, but we'll take a Piercing Darkness again for a champion.
Happy to do whatever's needed.
I like that.
He made it, Rip! I want to go home.
This one's trouble.
I could try playing the Time Trick first, and then do two, then Sharp Sight saves it. I think I like taking out the Young Witch more than the Fleet Feather Tracker, I think. I would rather, the problem here is that, you know, now we won't have any mana for a champion to, like, kill a champion. But I don't think I just let this thing terrorize me and, you know, quick attack Challenger. Yeah, Twin Disciplines saves, I guess, if I go after the Fleet Feather Tracker. That would change. Man, it's just kind of rough. If I play nothing, we bank 3. Just a really nice setup.
Yep. Team adventure time.
Really nice setup.
Come on, Rip.
Nothing beats field testing. Let's get started.
Yeah, I probably need to just play Financier and then be able to play a spell. I don't know. Yeah, they did have Twin Disciplines.
You could say I got a life wish.
All right, so play in the center so that we can have fast speed. Fast speed, piercing darkness.
Darkness and light.
Hammer! Full speed ahead!
Sure, boss.
So we're pretty dead to a rally. We're just pretty dead to everything. Man, this deck is just so good. You know, because it attacks for so much so fast. It has the challengers, and it has all, you know, sharp side and twin disciplines. And so if they have protection plus rally, we just kind of lose. I basically have two options. I either Piercing Darkness the Poppy or Shock Blast the two elusives. The Shock Blast the two elusives is better for my life total right now, but having them keep the Poppy alive and then be able to rally. If I Piercing Darkness Poppy and they rally, I'm taking lethal anyway. So I guess we have to do this. I guess this has to be the play. Yeah, then Ranger's Resolve is also another fantastic combat trick. So they have three fantastic combat tricks like that, and then rally. All right, so that's lethal. Level up Poppy. Makes this thing deal 7. Sure, just give it a loser 2. It was already lethal. And I have no mana. Oh, I guess it wasn't lethal. It was only impact 1. I don't know. Anyway, 0-1.
Sure, but never out.
This is a little different. So probably like a War Mother's Call or Field Rush. You know, probably like a ramp deck with that kind of stuff. I could see this being a pretty tough matchup for us, because, you know, like, we are kind of designed to, you know, get 3/3s in play, deal 3 damage to stuff, maybe do 5 damage to stuff with this Piercing Darkness, but that's kind of about it. I could certainly see them going much bigger than that. Perfect. That was the card that I really wanted to draw.
Let's make tomorrow today.
Forge Chief. I was thinking that. Because Forge Chief could allow us to go, Forge Chief on 1, Financier on 2, Forge Tomorrow on 3, and then still play a 6-mana card on 4. Because it can be multiple. Oh, I probably shouldn't have played this. I think I should have Thermogenic Beamed that. Okay, Atrocity and Brood Awakening aren't too exciting.
Let's go, people.
This'll take the chill off.
Okay, so they didn't add any mana. So they didn't have an 8+ cost card, and I don't think that they...
This is where the magic happens.
I don't think they drew one, because I think this was like the last card over here. Okay. So we're actually... You know, so it's actually good that I didn't Thermogenic Beam them.
You can see the Devastian border from here.
So I'll still take it out. Still get it out of here. Sentry's gonna block anyway. We'll just get it out of here. So we can hopefully attack for 7. Hopefully they just pass. There we go.
Watch your backs.
Yeah, Ballistus is. The Pharos is so good. I also included in my list, makes you free to not include Ruination. But if you need a matchup, you can find it. Exactly. This card is incredible. One of the very best cards in the game. Yeah. Like, they...
The Thralls are
They really printed some great, like, all the manifest cards are some of the very best cards in the game. Okay, so I think we go Piercing Darkness over Thermogenic Beam just so we... Because the Thermo is just more... Even though, like, we don't heal our Nexus there, it's just more flexible later on.
Bow to no one.
Okay. Thermo for 6. Good thing we held on to Thermo. And maybe this is take 7 and then Shock Blast for the other 3? Maybe? Doing something else. Okay, that will do. Let's go and surrender. GG's. Lurkers. Alright, you go away. We need a spell. Do we keep the second Eager Apprentice, right? So we're going to play, like, one Eager Apprentice, which is cool. And then, like, a 6-mana spell. And then, like, round 4, we could have, like round 3, a 6-mana spell. Then round 4, like, another Eager Apprentice and a Financier. But we need that 6-mana spell. Or, I guess, Forge of Tomorrow. Okay, so really getting punished for keeping that second Eager Apprentice, because we not only didn't draw the 6-mana spell, but then we just found another Eager Apprentice.
How can I help?
It's still the play, though.
Safety first.
Alright, so they missed Lurk, that's good. And our 6-mana spell is somewhere.
Quick hands make quick work.
Maybe it's on top right here. Yeah, there we go. All right, so Shock Blast those so they don't turn into being 3 power and being able to kill the Forge Worker. Yeah. I don't know, do I want this Ixtali Sentinel? They're supposed to take that Sentinel.
Watch your head.
Watch out!
Okay. So they've lurked one time. That one card's a lurk card. I'll take a Dawning Shadows. Yeah, kill a unit like that. I'll take a Dawning Shadows. I'm not scared. It has to have 8 plus power before it gets overwhelmed.
For the wicked, for the dead, I bring rest.
Sure, boss.
Watch your toes.
So getting the Senna in play, we can maybe try to level up the Senna, you know, get 3 slays with spells.
Gently, gently.
That's the first one right there. Okay. Yeah, like, we have this right now, right? Like, they just don't really have anything left. They miss Lurk a couple of times, and we have a ton of good removal still. So. Thralls. We don't have any landmark removal. No aftershocks here. I do think Thralls is good against Jayce. I've talked about that in the past. I think that's a good way to fight Jayce decks. Is with Thralls. Is Jayce decks kind of have to play aftershocks to keep up, but I don't actually have any aftershocks in here. So I'm trying to think of like something that the Pharos Financier can hit to get rid of this, and I don't know what that would be. Alright, so we have to hope that they don't have round one Frozen Thrall, which they did. So now we have to hope they can't, like, double this up a lot, right? So, like, no promising future. Like, if it's just 188, we'll probably be fine, but hopefully no promising future. No Talia.
I will bury the world in ice.
Good for you. Transform a follower into an exact copy of another follower. So basically we can turn an 8-8 overwhelm into like a 2-2. That sounds pretty cool. Yeah, Valiant says I played Thralls all yesterday and only really lost the decks with Scorched Earth, win 11-2. Yeah, I think Thralls is awesome. It's really good. So yeah, that sounds about right. I don't really want any of those. I guess we'll take the Shock Blast. I guess they're just waiting for me to tap under Aftershock mana, I guess. So they did have Promising Future. Now if they also have Talia, then it's just, you know, game over. GG's, but alright, so this would leave them with an 8-5, and then I have 5 mana, and so I can either... I could either Thermogenic Beam the 8-5, or Thermogenic Beam the Lissandra. Is it better to kill the 8-5 right away, or just... It's probably just better to kill the Lissandra so they don't get, like, Ice Shards, right? Say yo-ho with the Twitch Prime sub. Thank you so much for that resub. Now 6 amazing months. You are amazing. Thank you so much. Yeah, Thralls is definitely a tier 1 deck. I guess we can just Eager Apprentice first and then kind of get some more information which line we want to go with, Thermo, Shock Blast, Assembly line. You know, obviously considering playing this with the lifesteal thing, but we'll pass on that. So otherwise I could like assembly line and get 2 3-3s and, you know, maybe block a little bit, Shock Blast, save Thermo. I don't know, we could try that. We definitely need to try to start doing damage. Fight. And they had double Promising Future. This is a really good Thrall's hand. Frozen Thrall in round 1, Lissandra on 3, and double Promising Future. So deck this good. Sure, with Italia. Isn't going to lose very much. A deck this good with this kind of hand. Alright, so 2 and 2. We still have our opportunity for a 3 and 2. But Thralls is pretty favored against Jayce decks. Especially if you can have this kind of hand. I had to hit, like, Pharaoh's Financier that hits. I guess we're going to have to do this card, aren't we? I want to play the Sentinel because of the lifesteal, but I guess we're going to have to play Senna so we can have fast speed. But I was going to say we need, like, Pharaoh's Financier to hit Ruination. Sure.
Concentrated forgiveness. Keep your distance.
Fast speed ruination do anything? Yeah, like if we get a fast speed ruination.
Loss is nothing new. Keep moving.
Shen Poppy. So we lost to two of like the very best decks in the format that had absurd hands. Decks that like I would lose to with no matter what we play. So there's been no shame in either loss. I think we still send the Senna back. That's the one that I wasn't sure about, but you know, Senna turning stuff into fast speed could be really nice.
Come on, people, let's make tomorrow today.
I don't even know what that means.
Let's go,
how do you make tomorrow today? Because then it wouldn't be tomorrow anymore. I don't know how you make tomorrow today. True Shot Barrage? That's always fun.
Awesome day for progress.
Watch your back.
River shape the land and give it life.
There is life yet within me.
Do not river shape the land. Do not give it life.
A gift from the river folk.
What remains?
Alright, good card for them. Going.
I fight for a brighter tomorrow.
I walk the space between worlds.
Everything's slow speed. I could try to, like, you know, piercing darkness like one of these things, but I think they definitely protect it with, like, a, you know, sharp sight, twin disciplines, anything like that. So doing this gets rid of two, you know, like, makes it, like, where they'd have to, like, try to protect every, you know, like, it's a lot of things to protect. Now, they obviously can attack, barrier, kill Jayce. Wasn't too much I could do about that anyway, but then they have to, like, use a spell to, like, protect Shen.
Clearance, pal.
The Forge of Tomorrow. Keep it up. Wish we had things that weren't slow. Yeah, this is like where we really need a Vial Feast, right? Like, Vial Feast, Mystic Shot, our deck's not playing either of those kind of cards. And, you know, like, I try to, you know, play this expensive spell to try to, you know, kill a Shen and then just use a barrier card. This is where we're really hurt there.
If it's a people problem, I'm your man.
Or everything being slow really hurts. Cards over there. Okay, got to kill a Shen.
The balance requires a watchful eye.
I'll say I didn't expect to kill a Shen. Yeah, I got nothing there. Sorry, GGs. So we saw there, and really that was like a lot like the first Demacia Ionia deck. I think Demacia Ionia, like, this kind of has a real problem against Demacia Ionia, everything being slow speed and everything being, you know, expensive and damage based, but like not very much damage for being really expensive, right? Like 6 mana is dealing 3, 6 mana is dealing 5, that kind of stuff. Whenever you're facing Twin Disciplines, Sharp Sights, even, you know, but then barrier cards, Ranger's Resolve, you know, that's all kind of a problem. You know, that. Basically, those games, we showed that why Vengeance, Ruination, those kind of cards are really good, right? Like, Piercing Darkness doesn't kill stuff, but, like, Vengeance would kill stuff, right? And then, you know, even, like, the matchup against 8-8 Overwhelms. And so, yeah, those were all matchups that we needed, Ruinations and Vengeance and that kind of stuff. And Piercing Darkness, Shock Blast, not so good against Twin Disciplines, Sharp Sight. So, there we go. That's how it is. I think I would definitely rather just have, like, you know, Vial Feast, Mystic Shots instead of, like, Solari Sentinel, you know, creating a Darkness. A Darkness just isn't, you know, 3 mana slow is just not a good card. You know, it's really not. So I'd rather just have Vial Feast and Mystic Shot and that kind of stuff instead of that. But there we go. All right, so that was Jayce Senna. You know, first try, again, you know, like, this is, you know, a viewer put this together, submitted it, first try. I think that it could do better. I think that it, you know, like, it was really relying on the financier to find Vengeance and Ruination, but there's so many options here, it's hard to always find those cards. We did get a Dawning Shadow once, and I do like Dawning Shadow, but I think that relying, this build here went too much on trying to make Senna really matter with slow into fast, and I think that that was a hindrance on it, because anytime Senna's not in play, you're just overload on slow spells, and that's a huge negative. And so I think there's got to be a lot more fast spells in here to pair alongside it. But anyway, that's going to be it for Jayce Senna. So those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button. And if you've been playing Jayce Senna yourself, because I know this has been kind of a popular archetype of people like trying stuff out and everything, let us know all about it. Let us know in the comment section, you know, what are you trying with those two champions? What's working for you? You know, anything like that. If you got a deck list that you want to put in the comment section, feel free for other people that want to play this kind of archetype, definitely do that. definitely do that. I think we did get some kind of tough matchups to Demacia Ionia decks that I talked about with just like our removal suite. I think Demacia Ionia is going to be really tough for us. And then Thralls. Thralls is really tough for Jayce too. So we had three decks overall that I think were really poor matchups for us, and kind of exposed the weaknesses that the build had. So you got ideas to shore those kind of decks up? You know, like how do we beat Demacia Ionia decks? You know, let us know. And Thralls, let us know in the comment section. But that's going to be it for Jayce Senna. So as always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you for the next video.